You probably agree that Excel pivot tables make it really easy to analyze a lot of data quickly. Now, in case you aren't familiar with pivot tables, I have a video that gets you started in 10 minutes. But before you jump there, make sure you watch this video just so you get to see how cool pivot tables really are. Now, the first pivot table feature that many ignore is recommended pivot tables. This feature makes it really easy and super fast to get started with your first pivot table. So over here in Excel, I have this marketing data set. We have the date, campaign name, responsible person, the location these campaigns were running, impressions, clicks, units sold, and ad spend. So we have 150 rows of data. This is formatted as an official Excel table called marketing data. To get started with my first pivot table, all I need to do is go to Insert and select recommended pivot tables because I might already find what I need right here. On the side, we get to see some suggestions. First one is units sold by responsible person and campaign name, ad spend and units sold by location. Whether something matches exactly what you want or it's kind of like what you want, it's still super fast to get started like this because you get to decide if you want it on a new sheet or an existing sheet. The moment you click this, you already have your pivot table. And either you go with this or you modify it as you need. So for example, let's say I wanted to add location to my pivot table. I'm just going to drag and drop it in the rows. Now I get to see units sold by responsible person broken down by location as well as campaign. If this is too much information and I don't need campaign, I can kick it out and drag location to the columns. Getting started with the recommended pivot tables makes it less scary to start your analysis. The next feature a lot of people miss is inbuilt dynamic formatting. So for example, you've created this pivot table and you want to keep your eye on some of these numbers. For example, let's say Gustavo was very successful in his campaigns that he ran in fast food sites, and we want to keep track of this. So I'm just going to format this cell using standard formatting. So I'll just give it an orange background color. I'm going to make it italic and bold. Okay, so I've basically formatted this cell. But check this out. What I formatted here isn't cell E5. It's actually the number, the units sold for Gustavo for the fast food sites. What I mean is this. If I bring up the field list and I grab location and drop it here, take a look at this. That formatting came with. If I bring responsible person to the filters, it's gone. But I don't have Gustavo here. If I change this dropdown and select Gustavo, I get to see the highlighting. If it's someone else, that highlighting is gone. So whenever you don't want to lose track of a key item, you can use this inbuilt dynamic formatting. Next overlooked feature is the conditional formatting icon inside your pivot table grid. What I mean by that is this. I have a pivot table here showing the units sold by responsible person and campaign location. Now what I want to do is add conditional formatting to units sold by location so that I take one quick look at this and I can see which locations sold the best and which ones the worst. So what I'm going to do is just click on a single cell that I want to conditionally format. This is, for example, one of them. And I'm going to go to Home, Conditional Formatting, and select the conditional formatting of my choice. I'll go with data bars and go with solid fill. Now, Excel just applied the conditional formatting to that selected cell, but take a look at what's beside that cell. That's the icon I'm talking about. When I click on this, I see more choices. I can apply the conditional formatting to all cells showing sum of units sold. This applies the conditional formatting to every single number, including the totals. Well, I want to exclude the totals. I just want to apply to units sold by location. That takes us to our last item, all cells showing sum of units sold for location. And that's the conditional formatting applied. Now, if you want to edit the conditional formatting, you can go back to Home, Conditional Formatting, Manage Rules, select a rule, edit it. Let's say I just want to show the bars. I don't want to see the numbers. I'm going to place a check mark here. And now with just one quick look, I can tell that Gustavo Fast Food Sites is doing really well. And email campaigns for Jesse is doing really bad. Probably has to work on his language skills and tone, I assume.
Yes! Hell yeah!
Next is not taking advantage of custom number formatting. So going back to this report, let's say I want a separate column to show units sold as numbers, and I want to have my bars separately beside it. So I'm going to grab units sold and add it a second time here. Now you're probably familiar with the standard number formatting, right? If I want to add a 1000 separator to these numbers, I'm just going to right mouse click on any of the numbers, go to number format, number, use 1000 separator, and zero decimal places. Now down here, you have the ability to add a custom format. So whenever you can't find the type of formatting that you want from these standard formats here, you can go to custom. In this case, I'm okay with this. I'm just going to go out. But for this column here, I want a custom format because I want to hide these totals. It doesn't make sense to show them underneath the bars if I'm showing them in this column here. So I'm going to right mouse click, go to number format. This time, go to custom. Inside this box, I'm going to type in semicolon, 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 and that's going to hide all my values. Now let's just rename this to sales, and I'm just going to delete the header here and add a space. Here we use custom number formatting to hide the values, but there are so many tricks and use cases of custom number formatting, especially for pivot tables. For example, with a simple tweak, you can add plus and minus signs to clearly show positive and negative percentages. Or you can add symbols of your choice to your pivot table fields. Aside from custom formatting, there are many other design tweaks you can apply to pivot tables to give them a more professional look, or as my daughter would call it, to give them a more aesthetic look. I cover all the tricks in my new Excel Pivot Table Mastery course. If you're familiar with my content, you know that good design and presentation is just one aspect of the whole learning. In the course, we go in depth and I teach you how you can handle different real-world scenarios, because real-world comes with messy data. For example, dates can be a headache in pivot tables. Sometimes they can't be grouped properly. Sometimes dates aren't recognized as dates. Sometimes your data might be multiple sheets and you need to combine them together to create your pivot table. Sometimes you refresh your pivot table and it doesn't work. New data doesn't show up. There are so many things that can go wrong when you work with pivot tables, and in the course, I'm going to address all the common scenarios. So if you're interested and you want to find out more, check out the description box below this video. By the way, if you want to follow along with what I'm showing right now, you can download this file as well. You're going to find more details in the description of this video as well. Now let's move on to the next feature. Adjusting your default pivot table settings. So pivot tables are great, but what is this? This header adds zero value to my pivot table. What I also don't like with the standard pivot table layout is that it comes in compact form and it combines all the different fields in the same column. I prefer to split each field to its own column. So I usually go to design, report layout, and I change the layout to either outline form or tabular form. I'm going to go with outline form. I get each field in its own separate column and I get proper headers. Now notice another thing that kicked in was autofit. So every time you refresh your pivot table or you make adjustments like this, Excel tends to autofit your columns. And this annoys me most of the time, so I go ahead and turn it off. Just right mouse click, go to pivot table options, uncheck autofit column widths on update. Now, if you refresh your pivot table, everything stays as is. So I would love to have these settings as my default. So every time I create a new pivot table in any file, I get these settings applied. And guess what? I can. I just have to go to File, Options, Data, Edit Default Layout, and I can update my pivot table settings to whatever I want. If I want to change the report layout, I can do so from here. If I don't want to show grand totals or subtotals, I have the ability to turn them off. Under pivot table options, I can adjust any of the settings here. I could turn off auto fit if I want to. Now, if you already have a pivot table with the settings that you like applied, all you have to do is click on import and your changes are going to be automatically imported. And then when you okay this and okay this, this is going to be saved with your Excel application. You can go ahead and open any other file, create a new pivot table, and these settings will be applied. Next overlooked feature is report filter pages. What I mean by that is this feature right here under pivot table analyze options, show report filter pages. It's grayed out. Why? Well, if you take a look at my pivot table layout here, I have nothing in the filters. I have responsible person and location in the rows. For values, I'm showing impressions, units sold, and ad spend. Now, the moment I move something to the filters, so I'm going to bring responsible person and drop them here, and I go to options, show report filter pages is now activated. But what does this do? Well, let's say I needed to create a separate report for each responsible person. So Gustavo wanted to see his own report, and Walter wanted his report. Instead of changing the view and replicating the sheet, I can take advantage of this option. First thing I'm going to do is set it to all and then go to options, show report filter pages. You're going to see the name of any filters you have in place. I just have one. When I okay this, just keep your eye on the bottom here. See what happens. Each person gets their own sheet and their own data. So that pivot table is replicated. We can see the responsible person as the sheet name and as our pivot table filter. Okay, so this concludes my list of common pivot table features that people often overlook. So was there a feature that I covered that you had overlooked? If yes, let me know what that is in the comments. Also, if there is a pivot table feature that you had overlooked for a long time and you just recently discovered it, let me know what that is in the comments as well. By the way, don't forget that if you want to get more practice, you can download this file. You're going to find the link to it in the description of this video. Thank you for being here, and I'm going to catch you in the next one.